I'm attorney Laura Anthony, founding partner of Legal and Compliance, a full-service corporate securities and business transactions law firm. Today is the first in a LawCast series talking about distributed ledger technology, or blockchain. On July 13, 2017, FINRA held a blockchain symposium to assess the use of distributed ledger technology, or DLT, in the financial industry, including for the maintenance of shareholder and corporate records. DLT is commonly referred to as blockchain. The symposium included participation by the Office of the Comptroller of Currency, the U.S. Commodities Futures Trading Commission, or CFTC, the Federal Reserve Board, and the SEC. FINRA also published a report earlier in the year discussing the implications of DLT for the securities industry. Delaware, Nevada, and Arizona have already passed statutes allowing for the use of DLT for corporate and shareholder records. This is the first in many LawCasts that will discuss DLT as this exciting new era of technology continues to unfold and impact the securities markets. I will summarize the recent SEC investigative report on initial coin offerings and the conclusion that cryptocurrencies can be a security. I will also be completing a LawCast series summarizing the state blockchain legislation to date, including Delaware's groundbreaking statute. Blockchain is an openly distributed database which is used to continuously maintain a list of records called blocks. Each new block is linked to prior blocks in such a way that data cannot be retroactively changed in a prior block without changing all blocks, which is virtually impossible. Although technology is being developed to correct prior transactions on the chain. A DLT ledger is shared among network participants instead of relying on a single central ledger. The blockchain technology could be used to maintain shareholder records in a secure, immediate form, as well as to process capital markets trades instantaneously. It is thought that stock ledgers and any transfers would be updated instantaneously, effectively allowing for a T plus zero settlement of trades without the need for intermediaries. A change of this magnitude is in our trading markets is many years away, as effective regulation and consideration on market impacts will take some time. However, many top transfer agents are already developing blockchain systems for shareholder records, and some will be available for testing within a matter of months. The technology is already being utilized, most notably by the cryptocurrency industry. At least one industry leader, Overstock CEO Patrick Burns, TO Technologies, has created a system that could form the basis for a widely used blockchain technology which disrupts the capital markets trading systems. I don't expect quick changes to trading systems and settlement. Blockchain remains widely unregulated, and without consensus from top financial regulators, any changes to capital market structures would face roadblocks. However, I expect that the ability for public companies to maintain stock ledgers using DLT technology will be forthcoming very soon. I'm securities attorney Laura Anthony, founding partner of Legal and Compliance and producer of LawCast. Should you have any questions about today's topic, please visit securitieslawblog.com and lawcast.com or contact me directly. Inquiries of a technical nature are always encouraged.